All right. What is going on, good folks? Let me connect this thing like I'm supposed to connect this thing.
What's up, Sly?
What's up, SlyFox?
What up, JM? What's good? Let's get this thing started like it's supposed to be.
Yeah, in the studio. In the studio, studio.
Five, one, nine, one. Welcome again to another episode of Stirring the Pot. It's your boy DJ Sly Fox. Look like I got the usual suspects with me. Got Dr. Renee. Got Jason Michael. Let me say Jason Michael, two-time Trivia Night winner, Jason Michael. One time let's see, studio, one-time studio member of the year, Dr. Renee. Say she's trying for her second consecutive year. You know, that's coming up here soon. So see what we're gonna do this time. Say she still ain't got her certificate, but we're gonna make sure it happens. We got a paper signed, and we just being lazy, man. We got you though.
I know.
I sent an invite to a couple of well, more than a couple, but a few of my friends that I
Okay.
thought would add to the show. So
Good deal.
we'll
Good
see if
deal.
they show up or not.
You know how I feel. Like, if they show up, more power to us. If they don't, the show must go on. So with that being said, y'all seen we didn't really put many topics this week. We thought that this week we should have, I mean, we got a couple of talking points that we can hit, but we realized that throughout the week, some of these topics may get stale because you're going to hear about it over and over again, or some of them just might be to the point where, like, damn, they done beat the shit out of it. Let's not talk about it. But we decided that this week we were going to do a simple back and forth. Let's talk about it. What is going on right now in the world, social media or whatever that you want to talk about? Let's discuss it. Personal lives, advice stuff. If you guys got something for me, whatever. Let's just talk about it.
I don't know if you saw that post I put up from Barry White.
Yes. Okay. That was pretty cool.
Yeah.
I thought that RB had posted that. That's kind of shit that RB be posting. And I was like, damn, Barry White, old deep voice has got more to say than baby. I thought he was just trying to love on people, but he really had some insight 40 years ago. He was talking about how the machines are gonna take over, you know, how the technology is what it is. And I thought it was pretty funny because in music as a whole, like, music used to be you had a drummer, you had a guitarist, you had somebody on the keyboard. So now you can do all that shit just with one of these. Get one of
Right.
these, just put it together and make all that stuff. So Barry White was onto something back then, and then it goes further than that. How far have you seen it go so far?
I didn't see all of it. I just saw when he started talking about the computers.
Yeah, no, he went into quite a rant. And it was surprising for me because, you know, I'm thinking Barry White, always Barry White on there. He about to say some old sexy shit, you know. But he was speaking real because you know, that's one of the things he's talking about was how technology is gonna take over us. He said if you wanna have a future in this world, and he figured it was gonna be by the year 2000, but I mean, damn near. He said, if you want a future in this world, you need to either learn how to build these computers, fix these computers, or maintenance on them,
Program them.
program them. That's what he said right there. Program these computers. So, yeah.
So there's a I need to look for the article. There's an article that I was reading about a group of kids at Berkeley, and they're all like their majors don't have anything to do with music. They're mostly like math and science or whatever.
Yeah.
But what they were doing was they were experimenting with math and music, right? Because they go hand in hand. And they took like songs that were like hits from like each decade in the last like 5 or 6 decades. And they compared them to the same mathematical algorithms of those songs to music from like the 40s, 50s, and 60s.
Yeah.
And they basically threw it into this program and told the program, hey, make something unique from what we're giving you, right? Find randomness in this set of beats and time signatures and how the music was written and all of that. And so the program, at first, it came up with just like nonsense music that, while it was in time, it didn't make any sense. Like it didn't flow and it didn't, you couldn't write lyrics to it or whatever. But they said after like their fifth iteration of trying that the computer generated a song that you could write lyrics to.
Damn. Now AI doing way, way better than that now. They writing whole songs, words, voice accuracy. Yeah. I mean, Barry White, to be Barry White, you think anytime somebody say Barry White, two things I think of when I think Barry White. One of them ain't got shit to do with Barry White. One is he a nasty motherfucker, about to take my girl or something. And then the other one is them angry bears, angry beavers or whatever it was called. The angry beavers, they had a dude on there named Barry. And it was a bear, but he just talked like Barry White. And I was like, dude, that's some gangster shit. But yeah, hey, he said also what you was going to. A lot of people go to four years, 5 years in college, and then don't do what the fuck they went to school for.
Right.
I thought that was hilarious because my dumb ass went to art school. Now I get to use my shit ever so often, but the majority of my income definitely don't come from no damn art. So he was on point 40 years ago.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
When I saw that, I was like, whoa, okay.
Yeah. All right. So, what's a quick exercise? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I ain't got enough women in here yet. I can't do this yet. I feel like I was being biased. Holy shit. My man ain't got no snatch no more. Jason G, where you snatch? Oh, shit.
Shave it off, bro. It was time.
Say no shave November. To hell with it. He said he look evil. Is that what the evil laugh for? We were talking about that. We were talking about how, like, didn't we say something about it? Bad guys don't be having no mustache. That's funny. A little bit of good news up front. T.I. He did his affordable apartment development in Atlanta. Kudos to that brother. That dude been doing all kinds of shit to the neighborhood. So it's good he's doing something for the neighborhood. I say,
I said, and he had a little section for homeless kids.
Yes, I seen that. Yeah, that. I mean, mm-hmm. That's one of the things I always said about rappers and entertainers in general as a whole is like, you put on for your city by shouting out your city in the songs and stuff, but like, mm-hmm. What are you doing for your city? Like, I can say I always had a quite little beef, or not a really a beef. It's only a beef if the other person give a shit. But I had a little tit with Kendrick Perkins. I'm like, man, this dude, only dude that made it out of Beaumont, he ain't putting on. And then, man, I was lying to myself. Every time that dude get an opportunity to shout out Beaumont, Texas, he doing it. Then I come back. Then I come back to Beaumont. He got a center or whatever this shit called with his name on it. And come out, he come putting turkeys in the neighborhoods and shit. And I was like, okay, all right, cool. I misspoke. My bad. I be talking shit about this man for no reason. So that's what's up. I mean, I don't fuck with Beaumont, but what happened?
I say being a whole hoe out in these streets.
A whole hoe. I slandered that man's name every chance I got. It was just because of one incident in school. And I ain't used to people from tall ass people. So when I bumped into him, I think his dick brushed my shoulder and I ain't like this shit. So I was beefing with that dude forever. So yeah. It was an incident. I wasn't cool with that shit.
The thing about it, I never had a problem with him. Not that I know him that personally, but he was just always approachable.
Yeah.
He never carried himself like he was better than everybody.
Right. So, I mean, but know, and anytime I got a chance to, when he was playing for the Celtics, I was like, man, I went to school with that dude. So, you know, whenever it came in handy for me to use, I was like, hell yeah. But when it was like, man, fuck that dude. He did nothing for the city. But, he did a lot. He did a lot for Beaumont, too. Because I look at Beaumont, I think cesspool was with a few hot chicks there. And, one in particular. But, you know,
And what kind of bullshit is that? You slandering him for not doing nothing for the city, but every chance you get, you slandering the city.
But I ain't from there, though. I'm not from there, though. Like, I'm from Prescott. Listen. I love my city. I go to my city every chance I get.
I've been there.
What you going to say about it? What's up, Jason Mike?
I'm not sure if we going to get into these topics or not, but
I said it's freestyle, whatever you want. If you want to bring it up.
I'd like to talk about that post that I made about the internet and the culture shift happening and the acceptance. The majority became those who were unaccepted. And when the majority, because the internet gave them a medium for their voice to be heard without restriction, the majority became those who were unaccepted. And now what they want to be accepted is accepted because they're the majority now, instead of the conservatives being the majority.
I can say this. My man RB has a very strong opinion on people who ain't never seen nobody in person, but got a lot of shit to say about them on the internet. What's your opinion on that, RB?
About what?
What we call keyboard warriors?
I mean, that's pussy shit.
That's what it turned into, in my opinion. That's what it turned into. I believe at first you had, I need some outlet to get, you know, a musician. This dude is weird, but now he's a musician. MC Hammer. Yeah, think about somebody like that. Dude was, he was okay on the scene, but whatever. But when he put his music out, that's when he was really heard. So, you know, I can see that's what the internet was for at first. But now, everybody get on there, and I think what RB3 says is accurate. It's like, pussy ass is on there just saying shit they never say in public. Never say in somebody's face. Hold on, let me see what Steve got, then I'm going to get back to Jason Michael so he can finish that up. What you got, Steve?
Nah, I was just saying that my opinion is the same thing as everything else. Like, yo, what you see is what you get and everything else like that. This generation has seen everything that's been accessible to them. So our generation that hasn't been accessible to everything else like that is, you know, susceptible to that. Like, we have our values, they have their values. We have to accept their differential between our values and their values. The problem is that, like, when you're trying to raise a generation of a crop of kids and things else like that, in that generation, in this generation now, compared to what we was and everything else like that, our styles clash. So you are going to either bend, or either you're going to fold or you're going to bend. You're going to have to either do either or. So what do you want to do with your raising of your crop? Me, look here, this is a dictatorship. This is not a democracy. You're going to do what I say, or you're not going to damn near grow. You're going to grow, but you're going to grow differential to what you're thinking the society tells you what it is. So, you know what I mean? Like, my daddy hates me. Nah, your daddy don't hate you. Your daddy just wants you to be proper.
Mm-hmm.
Well, better than you putting yourself out there to be. Man, I want to go all the way proper because, you know, I can't stand a proper person. My kids, when people tell me, oh, they're so proper, that, to me, it sounds like, I don't like how you said that. Like, they talk proper. I don't like
No. You can say, look here. You can phrase it however you want to. I'm going to phrase it the way I want to. I want you to be proper. I want you to be stature to the point where when somebody look at you, they look at you solid. And then when you see yourself in the mirror and everything else like that, you don't see yourself as solid. You see yourself way more than solid than what they see you as. That's my point.
Okay. All right. Jason Michael, go ahead and finish what you had on that.
So I wrote in college, you can get credit, college-based credit for life experience, right? And my professor said if I could get my paper published, that he would give me credit for like three different classes. Now, the paper that I wrote was a thesis on the causation of culture-specific behavior based on the inception of the internet. So I was theorizing that the internet itself caused the behavior of the generation that came after it, because it facilitated a medium in which there was no filter, right?
Mm.
Now, we're talking about the inception of the internet. We're not talking about what you know as the internet today, right? Because
it's different now. Yeah.
The beginning of the internet was literally ARP. Right. It was you post something on a board and you can go to a page and see what somebody posted. That was the beginning of the internet before there was like immediate interaction and all that. And my thesis was that because the internet exists, this behavior is now possible. Right. And so my paper was they agreed with my approach and my perspective and said that I had validity in my points, but because I had no data to back up my points, that it could never be proved true because nobody decided to take data points from the inception of the internet till the time I wrote the paper. So I couldn't show the gradual incline of that behavior changing and existing because that behavior, while it did exist in conjunction with the inception of the internet, I didn't have the data to back that up. Like I couldn't go back and say this set of instances occurred solely because the internet exists. And they said, because of that, they wouldn't publish the paper.
Wow. I mean, I guess you got to buy by the rules or something. They say you got to do a certain shit.
Well, I still believe that is causing for that behavior. I believe that the behavior that we see in today's society would not be accepted by society prior to the internet.
Yeah, no, I agree with that. We hear that every day from grandparents and parents that, you know, we don't call people anymore. We don't.
It's all about technology. Yeah, everything is over.
Text messages or FaceTime. And, you know, mm-hmm. I mean, I hate talking on the phone. I could sit there and just not have a phone all day and be fine with it, but
that's true though. I mean, the thing about the internet, and I'm going to agree with Jason Michael, because the thing about the computer and the internet and everything else like that is that information. It's not the fact that like the effects of, you know, personal beings and everything else like that change. It's the fact that God damn it, this nigga locked me the fuck out.
You locked yourself out. I swear you downstairs by yourself.
Yo, the fact that information has changed. Information has changed to the point where, like, you know, I mean, like,
they can't go figure anything out. Everything is right there in front of them.
Yeah, everything is right there in front of you. So if the information that changed in front of you is different from what you used to do and everything else like that, then you're going to fall susceptible to all of that.
So, well, let me piggyback off of Jason Michael's professors. What makes anything on the internet real? Like, what makes it correct? How do we know that you Google something and that's the right answer? You know what I mean?
Before like, you go, I don't agree with it.
What?
I don't agree with y'all stance on it, but I say
who
that
stands? Who stands? Because there's two different stances.
It seems like y'all saying the same thing about blaming the internet for the transgression.
So basically, while I was talking, you already had what you was going to say, ready to say, and you was like, I am not going to let him finish what you got to say because I want to disagree with everybody. Because what I was saying while you interrupted me was that I don't agree with that. And I want to say what the professor might have gave Jason Michael a disagreement about is how can you sit there and say this and this and this to be true if we don't know. Everybody, we got human beings typing in shit for the internet. Just like Wikipedia, we found out Wikipedia is not a reliable source for everything because people can sit there and change shit on there. Mm-hmm. There's not an end-all, be-all of what's right and what's wrong on the internet. And then we Google something, just like when we have the trivia. If I say an answer that supposedly is right, and then somebody say, hey, I think this was it. We can go look at that. Maybe it's questioned a different way, like the Mount Everest thing. What we talk about from the, is it the highest from the peak? Or are we talking about the length of it from the bottom of it to whatever, or is it the elevation, or it's different ways of putting it. And if we put this in a computer, the computer ain't going to give us, it's going to give us what they want to give us. It's not going to give us it's all the time exactly what we want. Jason Michael, what you got?
Let me give you a very simple example. Let's say, right, that you had never been introduced to fire, right? You didn't know what fire was. Right. But you as a person, right, were you not only did you have tendencies, but you had history of doing bad things with things that could hurt people. Right. And then somebody introduced you to fire. Right. Mm-hmm. And now that you have the opportunity to use that to do the things that you were doing before, because this is like up in the game. Right. Because now you've been introduced to fire and you can do so much more harm with fire than you could with what you had at your disposal before you knew what fire was, right? So if you had never been introduced to fire, then you couldn't have done the things that you were doing before with a worse harmful thing.
Hmm.
So if the internet, right? If the internet didn't exist, right, you would still have to use those same things that you had been using to hurt people, right? But now, right, you have the fire. Right? Now you
and
have
it's not as widespread. Yeah,
everything, right? Fire consumes everything. It consumes evidence. It consumes all that it touches, right? Yeah. And so my point is that the internet gave to the people an opportunity to enact the behavior that they had been want to react because they didn't have a medium to do it. And so now they do. So that's why I'm saying that the internet caused that behavior, because without the internet, they wouldn't have ventured to do that behavior.
Who created the internet?
The military.
So man created internet. So you still can't blame artificial intelligence. I mean, we're going to get to the point where we can. Huh?
I can't get with it. That's like blaming the gun instead of the dumbass that did
Shoot. Right. Yeah. And that's what I'm thinking the same thing with that question. I was like, well, you could blame the internet for what? Because everything goes back to the source and internet didn't create itself. It's not the, you know, what's that? The Big Bang theory. It didn't just poof and it appeared.
The internet gave people a tool to do shit they already wanted to do. It's like almost like somebody getting drunk and blaming on alcohol. They wanted to do the shit anyway.
Oh, I blame on alcohol all the time, sir.
I mean, you ain't never did nothing you ain't want to do when you was drunk. You ain't never got drunk. It was like, shit, I'm going to go suck some dick today.
Y'all know that.
Thank you.
Don't blame it on alcohol.
I'm so fucked up. I want to put a dick in my mouth.
Yo, for real.
I feel like it is what it is. All right, what they say, it is what it is. Pause. Hey.
Nah, you are susceptible to do shit that you may be too embarrassed to do sober, but that shit you want to do.
Yeah.
And in that the same way, somebody piss you off, you can call them all type of shit because the chance of you seeing them is relatively low.
Right.
Bitch, I'm gonna beat your ass, fuck your mama, you. But you see that person, I'm like, oh no.
Oh yeah.
Where did this theory come from that the internet was created by the military?
Jason Michael. KO said, where did the idea that the internet was created by the military come from?
No, the fuck I didn't.
I said KO said, not RB.
I know I'm answering somebody saying I locked him when I've been up here the whole time.
ARPNet was created by the military to help other military personnel communicate with individuals that were outside of the United States. If they were in a remote location, they created that medium, and they released that public shortly after 88.
Who told you this?
What's that?
Who told you this?
Who told me this?
Yes.
My uncle was part of it. He works for Cisco now. He helped do the networking work that started ARPNet.
The military has never created anything. Everything they got was from somebody else. Starting all the way back to Galileo with the looking.
I mean, there might have been some programmers that were
under contract to the military. I believe. I mean,
there might have been some contractors that were programmers that were asked to create the protocol that allows us to communicate. In that
it was created for them, baby, but they didn't create that motherfucker. That's for damn sure.
Well, okay, enlighten us. Who did create it?
Well, they like to say that the initial birthday of it was in 1983, but we didn't see that shit until the 90s. So it was like 1990, some dude named Tim Berners-Lee. He was a part of some other shit. It was funded by, what's his name? The fool that make the phones and shit.
Graham?
No.
Bell?
The Windows thing.
Microsoft.
D. Jobs?
Jobs?
He's talking about the other guy, Microsoft. Bill Gates.
Oh, Gates.
Yeah. He funded it.
But what do you define the internet as? Because
I was gonna say it's not the internet. www is not the internet.
The internet is a network of computers that are capable of speaking to each other. That was the inception of the internet. That was what ARPNet was. And when the military released it, they released it to the Ivy League schools to initially test it. And those posting boards were public back in 88, the Berkeley and Harvard and those Ivy League schools were allowed to use that network. They were allowed to access that network to post, you know, these boards so that they could test the system. The intention of the
the navigational system that was created for the military, but it was created by a lady who was an actress before named Hedy Lamarr. So a lot of stuff I know was created outside of it, and it was like sold to them for, you know, or created for them for that purpose. Just like the combat skills they use, but created by the military. A lot of them get taught karate. That's it from Japan. So I mean,
oh, I mean, the military are very heavily relied on contracts. So to say that the internet was used by the military first, and that would be more of an accurate statement. But whoever created it, created it. I mean, the military is a company.
Found the two computer scientists that that programmed the protocols of what we know today as the internet. They were obviously contracted by the military to develop the protocol that was used by ARPANET to develop a way for computers to talk to each other.
Rick, but for the most part, you're correct, though. But the two computers they had communicate with each other was adjacent from each other from other sides of the room. Like you have a
that's your last warning.
Like you could have an astrophysicist in one room, and on adjacent from that would probably be somebody who perfects napalm or something. You know? So yeah, for the most part, he's right. But I don't remember how far it can go when they first started. But I know the two rooms they had communicating was adjacent from each other.
I just want to be in the room where it happens. All right, that was a Hamilton reference. All right, well,
that's funny.
Thank
I
you.
Found this little quick paragraph to kind of support what Jason Michael was saying as far as it being before the 80s. It's from a website called PrisminianGroup.com, but it says, when, where, and whom was the internet invented? Unlike other life-changing but more self-contained inventions such as the light bulb or car engine, the internet was not invented by a single inventor as such. The prototype for the internet as we know it today came into being in the United States more than 50 years ago as a government weapon during the Cold War, when scientists and researchers used it to share data and communicate between themselves. What most of us think of as the internet today is only part of the information superhighway, which is really backed by a complex set of protocols and rules that were developed by computer scientists. The first scientific and academic network in the world known as ARPANET was founded in 1968. Long-distance networking between computers was first achieved in 1969 in an experiment between two research teams based in California at UCLA and Stanford.
Michael Wright, because the World Wide Web is what came out in 1969.
That's kind of my shortcut of what I was saying. Like, the WWW that we know as the internet came out
that's
in 90s.
The World Wide Web, that's different from the internet.
Yeah,
that makes Jason Michael
right
like a motherfucker.
Like a motherfucker.
I mean, I'm a software engineer and a computer. And I have a degree in computer science. So that my father was a robotics programmer for Martin Marietta that worked with NASA. So
Lockheed.
Now it's Lockheed. But I mean that's been part of my life, you know, since I was like 3-4 years old. So
SlyFox's been doing Van Sickle all his life. But when I met Van Sickle, that's what he was doing. Shit like that, building microchips and shit.
He was at Texas Instrument. Yeah. He was doing microchips, but he was putting them shits in calculators. So but that motherfucker could do a lot more than that. But yeah. So just a quick once around the room, as far as how many people here have been to college. And just to see what Barry White was talking about, how many people actually are making the majority of their money based on what they went to college for? And I'm talking about like college, not the trade, like trade school or whatnot, the smart route, because people believe that as soon as you get out of college, as soon as you got out of high school, you need to go to college, and that's, you already know what you want to do in your life. So with a show of hands, I'll go with Jason Mark first. Are you making the majority of your money based on what you went to college for, Jason Michael?
The subject itself, yeah. But because I work in tech, I would, and I'm speaking for people that can't speak for themselves right now. Uh-oh. I would say that, and this is a general number, I would say that at least 70% of all technical professionals who have a career in tech have taught themselves 60 to 80% of what they do on a daily basis at work.
Okay. And that you make the majority of your income from tech?
I do. Yeah.
All right. Benita, thing changed to Benita and Jason. Benita and Jason, it's two answers here. Both of y'all, college, make money?
So first of all, I need to explain something. Me and Benita got a bet tonight, so she can't speak. If she does speak, she loses the bet.
You won.
You cut, so they would know, because it's kind of weird if you don't talk.
Yo, what's the bet? I want to know what the bet. What's the bet?
She already talked, though. I heard earlier.
I did a little bit of college, so no. I don't make money from, because I don't have a degree.
What did you go to college for?
I mean, I was going in general, so I went to community college.
General studies. Classes,
but I didn't really have I wouldn't say fuck college, because it definitely helps you if you are looking to make money from the standpoint. If you have a degree, I think it gives you – it opens doors. I'll say that.
Yes, it helps.
But me personally, I don't have a degree. So, like, I've been working class since the 90s, and I've been able to get by. But I've noticed that people who do have degrees can have more opportunity. So,
And
I personally – don't have a degree, so I can't speak to that.
Does your bet stop Benita from answering questions, or is...
Correct. Although she can put it in the chat if you want.
Well, Benita, if you don't mind chatting with us, we would love to hear from you. Steve, did you go to college? And if so, do you make the majority of your money from what you went to college for?
Oh, no, bro. Trust me. I went to college. I got my degree, bro. I got my degree in instrumentation and everything else like that. Fuck no. In my field and everything else like that, it don't matter about the degree of what you have. It's about the people that you know.
So what did you go to college for?
I went to college for instrumentation.
What's
so
that?
That's more or less like it's an intermediate between an engineer and a process operator. So I'm in the middle. So I can troubleshoot take your designs and make whatever design that you have and troubleshoot that shit. And I can operate whatever you make. So basically, I'm an engineer and I'm an operator at the same time.
Okay.
So no, I don't make 150K. With overtime that I do make and everything else like that, I make 120K.
Yeah. Okay.
So no. So not at all.
Okay, Van Sickle, you went to college. You're muted for the first time in your life. Crazy, it's muted.
No, I didn't go to college.
Damn. So you was making that tech money without going to college?
Yeah, I like Jason Michael was saying, I've done computer repair. I was an engineer for Texas Instruments for like 3 years, and I taught myself.
Yeah. Okay. Couldn't.
And kind of like what Steve was talking about, like it's funny how you can go to college and get a degree, and then they're like, well, you don't have any experience. Well, they've spent the last few years out of high school in college, and of course they don't have experience. And then you get some jobs where you have experience as an engineer, but you don't have a degree, so they don't want to hire you.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Well, I'm going to give you my theory on that in a minute after I get to KO. I got you, Jason Michael. KO, you went to college, and is that what you're making the majority of your money in, if so?
Much like Jason Michael, they're under the same umbrella, electrical, but no, because my degree is in electrical engineering.
So you're not doing electrical engineering? What are you doing exactly?
Just electrical, period. Just electrical with my journeyman's license.
Oh, you got the certificates and licensing is what makes that thing. That's how security is.
It's okay. Two separate things. Yeah, it's two separate things. Okay. One I went to trade school for, one I went to college for.
Okay, bet. Let's ask the person with the most amount of degrees in here. Dr. Renee, with your degrees, is that your majority of your income from your degrees? What did you go to college for in the first place?
I went to college for accounting. When I was in college, no, that was not where I made the majority of my money from. I worked in the post office for 19 years. So from the time I was 18 till the time I was 38. When I left the post office, I started working in the accounting field. Hmm. And I was making more at the post office, believe it or not, because I was a supervisor.
Yeah. For sure.
What degrees do you have, Dr. Nat?
I have an associate's in specialized business in accounting. I have an associate of arts in accounting, a bachelor's of science in accounting, a master's of science in accounting, and I'm working on my doctorate.
You ain't see her wall? All the degrees on it?
I also have a paralegal diploma and a private investigator diploma and a forensic computer examiner diploma.
Yeah.
So she be seeing our bullshit.
Yeah.
She gonna kill us in paperwork for real.
Right. Drown us in that shit.
My wife wants to tell you how many degrees she has.
Okay. All right, Jason Michael, you up anyway. Well, let's talk to Kim. Kim, what degree? What did you go to? Kim. Kim, I got you, RB. It's cool. Kim, you always close us off. What you got?
I have a master's degree in school counseling, and I'm a school counselor.
That's what you make your money in, right? So from that scenario, we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. All right. So that's 8, definitely not 9. RB, close us out. What you went to college for, and do you make that most amount of money in? I love that jacket, Jason Michael. I want to give me one.
Criminal justice, then I do not.
Bishop got it for me.
That motherfucker. Okay, criminal justice, you do not. Mm. All right, so what I'm seeing is 8 out of 8, 9 people, because we're gonna count Kim too. Yeah, you got 2 people, I believe, who degree has put them in a position to make their the majority of their money. And everybody else figured it out on the fly, because I believe, and this is my little piece I was going to give y'all at the end. I think that from my experience, and this is just my experience, from every job that I've gotten, it was, oh, you got this experience. You got this experience. But they would love for you to have a degree or some paperwork, some certificates or some shit like that. So what I've done, how I built my career, was basically just I got my experience. And I started just doing random classes. I got a level 3 of insecurity. Like I said, with my art degree, that don't mean shit, because I'm technically 3 credits away from a bachelor's in arts. So I only have my associate's.
What's the problem? What's the problem?
Because I don't, it's pointless. I think it's pointless, so I don't do it.
Well,
so
I mean, 3 credits, come on. One class.
I have more kids than I need credits. So let's just put it in perspective. I don't got time for this shit.
One class. Oh,
it is.
God.
It's the final class. It's the portfolio class. And I just was like,
He do ever give each credit needed.
but the fact of it is like, I can go do that whenever I want to. All my credits are transferable. So it is what it is. If I get to the point where I'm like, oh, my God, I need that one more piece of paper, then I'll go do it. But as of right now, I got the jobs that I've been working in the last 5 years ain't got shit to do with art. It's more of a hobby than what's bringing in the money. So,
yeah.
And I get my certificate whenever I need a certificate. Hold on. Let me get Jason Michael. He got his hand up. Go ahead, Jason Michael.
Yeah, and I think that TVV can definitely – attest to this, but in the tech field, by the time that you get out of college, everything that you learned in college is obsolete. So what you learn in college outside of the foundational stuff doesn't even apply to your field. And so you're forced to learn on the job more, because technology moves so fast these days that what you did know yesterday is not even useful today. So
it's every 4 years. 4 years, every pretty much it's all tech revamps.
It's funny he said that because it's opposite. It's the same with electrical, but the opposite with engineer, because the electrical code book comes out every 3 years. They make a new one because electrical changes so often because of the new shit that's being designed. But
they got to change every time when you got shock yourself. So
most of the time when I got shocked Friday, Wednesday.
Your ass gonna be in the handbook, a picture.
But no, for real, what made me feel like I would be a better electrical engineer is because I work in the field as an electrician. So it does help with that, because the people coming out of school, everything you learn is based off theory. And I'm basing it off what I know, what I see every day.
Absolutely, yeah.
In addition to that theory.
That good old experience.
Right. Yeah. So it does help with the engineering side, but without the, you know, but not with the, you know, electrical in the field side, actually twisting wires and shit together. But my question was for everybody, though, for the people who hadn't or who aren't working in the field that they went to school for, or it could just be open to anybody. Is there any of y'all here that feel the desire to return back to school for something totally different? Me personally, I feel like I definitely gonna go back for astrophysics. I want a PhD in astrophysics.
I'm with you.
Right, that sound effect.
I would go back. I would go back to school for astrophysics if I could. Yeah.
Yeah. Oh wow.
I'm going to. I want, and I'm not stopping until I get a PhD.
If I decided to do anything, I would just go back for business. That's it.
I would go back to school for nursing.
My wife would go back.
You said nursing, Steve?
I would be a RN.
That's definitely a Beaumont answer.
I was going to say the same thing. Medical field has more opportunities than tech field, which is kind of weird, but
everybody getting shot in Beaumont, so it makes sense to be an RN.
Makes sense. An hour.
I would go because my mom was an RN and everything else like that. Everybody in my family was in the medical field. Either they was an LVN or RVN or traveling like nurse. So it makes sense.
In the ER, make $75 an hour in the state of Florida.
God damn.
They make banks. So it's not even, for me, it wasn't about the bank. It was about the fact that, like, I could connect with people. So me, I just want to connect with people.
Oh, then shit, go volunteer then. You want to connect. That ain't about the
average
money.
The average lawyer.
Oh, no, fuck that shit. I want to get paid.
Steve, you sound like a DJ, bro.
Yeah, I want to get paid, nigga.
On top of that, Steve, you and Van Sickle might look good in scrubs, bro.
Wow. That was a good
I do. I've been in elder care for the last 2 years.
Today. Hey, now real talk, though. I was thinking about that when Van Sickle said that. Man, you sound like a DJ. Real talk. If you are a DJ that works 5 hours a night, that's 5 hours for 7 nights. What's that? It's 35 hours a week? Yeah. You work 35 hours a week. You can make more than I make in my job. When I get paid $25 an hour and I work 8 hours. That's fucking ridiculous. That's crazy. That's some horseshit.
But you got to work your way up to get that kind of pay, man. You got to promote, build yourself.
My first gig outside of Yups paid me $250 just to work 5 hours. And I only did 4 hours because for the first hour, I couldn't figure out how the equipment worked. So, yeah. $250 for that one
time.
They
needed your help.
They needed all kinds of help. But anyway, let's move forward. I had RB posted. Oh damn, I pushed the button. Son of a bitch. That's the problem with having shit on your phone. So I pushed the button on my phone and it said, oh, the lady with the titty milk. Okay. The public feeding, man. Okay, my man RB says she's back. So RB, what's going on with this lady? All I see is a picture of a big ass titty, and for some reason I see panty drawers. Why I see panty drawers in public?
She gets by selling her soft porn, but hide behind she's breastfeeding that baby.
Okay, so do you feel like, okay, so you just said it, soft porn, instead of just breastfeeding the baby. Okay, done deal. We'll do that.
I mean, was it just breastfeeding if you breastfeeding the baby but squirting the milk on the camera with the other one?
I mean, maybe she needed to, what you call it? My wife used to do it called evacuate the ducks or some shit. On the other
Wait,
one,
hold up. She got some clout from that titty video. Now she's marketing that.
No, if you look at her page, she got almost hundreds of videos of her breastfeeding that little baby.
He's 4 years old, though.
But I know that dude big as fuck. He's so big.
There you go, Jason Michael. That motherfucker old.
Hey, I'm tripping on this, though. Why is her panty drawers showing while she's breastfeeding? Like, what does her panty drawers got to do with breastfeeding at all?
Because she doing her low-key porn. Her softcore porn.
This is the video I got right here. This is the picture. More. I should not see panty drawers if you just breastfeeding.
Look here, I look here. I'm looking at everything. I'm looking at titties.
We'll talk about that.
Yeah, I'm looking at everything. I'll say for every nigga that's damn near degraded and everything else that trashy that come across my timeline. Yes, I'm looking at all that shit. What you talking about? Like, you gonna show me titties and panties and a camel print? Yes,
camel print. I don't know. She's kind of big. I don't think she had a camera print. It was just the big old.
Like surface. My wife said, what about the kid when he grows up, right? And he's like, what? There's a video of me at 4 years old
sucking on titties.
Like,
yo, not only that, the kids that's gonna teach. Think about Kim Kardashian kids in school talking about your mom's a whore. I seen her sucking dick on camera. This dude, bruh. You a titty baby for real. Like, all the titty baby jokes is about to throw this man's way. He about to be the titty baby milkman. He gonna be all kinds of nicknames. And it's because his mama want to make some fame off of showing her big ass titties out there.
And ain't no way to stop it.
It's a done deal because of what? Because of the damn internet.
Like, yep, I'm a titty internet. Baby.
There it goes. Internet again. Like...
It's one of those catch-22s because if you offend it, where she's just breastfeeding, but everybody knows it's more than that. It's her exposure. I'm with Benita. Me and Benita was talking about it. Did she get the kid the okay to him being on camera?
In the camera? Right. Jason G. What do you think about this? Like you are our champion on defending the ladies, and I want to As the man who defends the lady, I want to know your point of view on this.
It's a little unusual, but ultimately, I'm not tripping off of the video itself because essentially, I feel like we're still in a state where people sexualize breasts, and so that's where people's uncomfortableness is. Also, just a random, like, I don't know why I can't turn my video on, but
I'm sorry, I turned it off. It looked like it was some hair. See if that works.
Jason G made me drop my damn airhead.
And you shouldn't have been showing it off. Stupid airhead boy.
But yeah, like at the end of the day, I just feel like, you know, it's uncomfortable because from a conservative standpoint, like we tend to not look at the breast when a child is being fed as sexual. And so I think it's that thing where she's pretty confident and comfortable in using the breast for what it's for, which is feeding the child, but also, you know, she's sexualizing it at the same time. So people are like, yo, that's a problem. And from a traditional standpoint, I don't think it should be, but I know why people are uncomfortable with it.
Right. Well, my Steve got a question for you, I believe, but I'm going to say this real quick, Steve. Have you ever seen Me, Myself, and Irene?
It's been a while, but yeah, I think I remember seeing it.
Yeah, that's when I see her, that's what I think of. When she's breastfeeding in public. Now, I don't have a problem with a woman breastfeeding in public because she had the towel over, you know what I'm saying? I think that's the right, you know, that's the right way to do it. But when my man, he had a problem with it. So he made it be known by going over there and feasting. He feasted himself as the messed up psycho cop guy. But I don't feel like that was an appropriate reaction. But at the same time, maybe he was raised thinking, I see a titty out in public, I'm supposed to suck it. Who knows? I don't know. go ahead, Steve. What you got, man?
All I say is, like, when you say about pulling out a titty in public and everything else like that, what you think every man's supposed to see? A titty. Okay? It ain't about the child. It ain't about the child and the mother. It's about the titty. So if you could damn near, you know me, limit the exposure of the titty for everybody that's supposed to be looking at everything else like that outside the titty, then you wouldn't have a problem with it. The problem is the insecurity of the fact that, like, she's pulling out something that's vulnerable to her insecurities and your insecurity as a relationship couple. Period.
I like titties. Not gonna lie. I'm a fan.
I love titties. I'm a fan of titties. And you pull out a titty in front of me, and I don't give a fuck what's sucking that motherfucker. Nigga, I'm gonna look at the titty. So, thank you. So, that's my point. Make her less insecure about that shit. You got pumps. You got everything else that can secure milk out of her titty, out of that shit. Do that shit there. Don't pull that shit out in public. If you don't want your woman to feel vulnerable, or you don't, she want to feel like I'm emasculated. I feel like I'm independent.
Steve, hold on. You going? Yeah. I want you to bring it in because I want to ask you this. At what point do you take accountability for being able to control yourself? If you see a titty out on the street, you just gonna go suck it?
As far as myself?
Yeah. Because that's where you're going with it right now. You like, man, she got that titty out. I'm supposed to suck that.
Because you making that shit like I am a assault of a victim. No, she's not a victim. You're making her as a victim of me assaulting her. Don't do that shit. She is the one pulling out the fucking titty. How am I the fucking in the wrong of looking at her doing the damn the suspect shit out of society values of everything? Like, yo, let me ask you a question. When do any woman pull out her titty, period?
Whenever, like, sometimes it hurts, sometimes it, you know, maybe she has reasons.
Oh my God.
Her favorite band's on stage.
Let me get Vansicle. He got his hand up. Hold on, Vansicle got his hand up. What's up, Vansicle?
All right, so I particularly, like, don't care for titties that much, man. What? Whatever. Like, I mean, I don't care too much. But, like, in Europe, Africa, and South America, man, it's not a big deal. Women being topless is so much more common. I'm not trying to take any which kind of side here, but kind of like Matt was saying, like, at a certain point, when it's men making more of a deal out of the titty, that's when it might become scary to somebody. You know what I mean? Like, damn, this motherfucker just saw my titty out, now he want to lick it, you know? Like, maybe that might be the problem, you know? If we weren't so conservative here, titties weren't such a big deal.
I love titties.
They're not. Every second person in the world got them. For every girl that don't, there's a fat dude somewhere that fills in the gap. You know what I'm saying?
They shouldn't be breastfeeding a child.
Hey, hold up, DJ RB 3000, hand up.
RB got his hand up. What happened?
I hit it, but that shit don't bother me, because if you went up to that same woman and be like, you look like you ready to breastfeed with all that milk, she'll be offended in the motherfucker.
Facts.
That's some milk field knockers right there.
Look at them. What they call them, milkers. Look at them milkers. Yeah. Like,
bro. At 4 years like old, you ready to feed.
He's not benefiting from the breast milk.
At that point. Not benefiting. Well, no. He hasn't been benefiting from that shit forever. But guess what? He's benefiting when her mom, when the mommy bring back that check from some of them videos. That's the benefit.
As big as them things, so I bet you lactate all day.
No, it has nothing to do with the child.
And I say that to say, if you're gonna be offended if the wrong guy makes a comment about your breasts, then you sexualize them yourself. So don't complain when other people sexualize them.
I ain't gonna lie. When I wear my
dad bod onesie, this, I done already lost anyway.
Damn, that's what I'm talking about. Children,
First y'all say women be overestimating their value, like a body part, just a body part. It ain't all special. I mean, but then somebody pull out a boob. How is that different from a man walking around shirtless? Like, what are we overestimating our value of our body parts or not? Y'all can't have it.
It's Hollywood.
I don't see women running around trying to suck on our nipples, even though some of them do it. I don't see them running around like.
Really.
Hey, but I'm saying I don't see a woman be like, shit, I gotta suck that bitch.
Hey, Jason Michael, what you got, dog? That's fucked up.
So, I mean,
it ain't even been an hour. I already lost.
The point of breastfeeding is to provide the child with nourishment because they can't consume nourishment on their own. So, to do it beyond the point, to not teach the child that it is appropriate to consume foodstuffs on their own. You're doing a disservice to the child and yourself because now that child, right? Because breastfeeding, right, is not sexual. Breastfeeding is neutral, right?
Yeah, but
it's neutral. It's for the infant, for the child who can't.
Wait.
Hold on real quick. It's because it just turned 10 o'clock. My bad. I apologize. For the duration of this show, I know this is a shameless plug, but I don't give a fuck. For the duration of this show, those raffle tickets for the PS5 will be $5. All right. So go ahead and finish, Jason.
So what I was saying is that I'll get 10 and you already got those set aside. Venmo's on. So the point that I'm making is that not only are you providing a path that is going to detrimentally affect this child in the future, but you're also, right? You're also preventing that child from realizing that consuming your breast milk, if you can still make it 4 years later, at that age, that they're doing something that is not natural.
But they need to learn how to eat.
Right? Because they need to learn to eat food. They need to learn to you know, consume sustenance outside of your breast milk. Because if they don't, and something happens to you, then you've provided a bad environment for the child. So it's not healthy regardless.
Okay. Facts. I mean, yeah, that's true. Benita and Jason, what y'all got?
No, I guess I disagree primarily because I understand it to be both. And so,
what
like,
part do you disagree with?
Like, this idea
is being the neutral.
Yeah, like, breasts are sexual, like, and they feed children, so it's just like they do two things. So like, I'm like, I understand why people are uncomfortable with it, but at the end of the day, like, no, I'm not gonna be like, no, that's just for the child, I'm not going to go there. Like, bro, I have fun with breasts.
Okay,
I can say this. I can honestly, he said, I have fun with breasts.
That's the issue, is that it's both sexual and it's both nurturing,
right?
So people are having trouble.
But what Jason Michael was saying, the purpose, what God made them things for, that's what he was getting at. I agree.
No.
God made them for both.
Thank you.
God made them for
both. The case, it wouldn't feel that great.
You know what, Adam? Oh. Let me put these things right here for
I think y'all getting y'all feelings mixed with logic and everything else like that. Like, okay. If we asking about titties, what do you feel about them? And then what's the logic behind the purpose of it? See, the purpose and the feelings are two different things. get one thing that y'all want to figure out, what y'all want to serve, and then kick out the other. If you want titties, I love titties. I'm gonna fuck with the most. I ain't got no purpose other than fucking with them hoes. You know what I mean? So, you know what I mean? Like, yo, when I see them hoes out in public and everything else like that, I want to see titties. I want to see titties. But as far as like the purpose of them nurturing the child and everything else like that, I want to see that shit behind closed doors. I don't want to see that shit in public. Only because I know that there's other people out there in the world that don't discern the 2023 discernment. Discern the fact that like titties for nurturing children and everything else like that are for growing, developing, and everything else like that for children.
I'm gonna tell you, Steve. I'm gonna tell you why I disagree with what you're saying, because titties is a sexual word. Breast is what are for children. But I'm not even gonna go that far. Steve, you ever busted a nut on a pair of titties?
I have not yet done that. I want to.
So you plan on doing that. If you plan on doing that, you are a nasty bastard, because somebody, some kid mouth is gonna be on them titties and you just ruin everything.
If he do that, it will be kids on the titties.
Okay, go ahead, Steve, and I love ass,
but I can't just grab ass because it's hanging out there. You can't just walk up to a titty and just start sucking on it, Steve. That's a violation, like a real violation.
All right, hold on to the actual subject. Okay, there you go.
Why don't we just ignore all this shit and get to the real issue? If you really are just breastfeeding, why do you need to film that?
That's the point.
Ultimate cheeseburger question.
We all know that what she's doing is why she's doing. She's doing it for a monetary gain. It is what it is. But it is a fun subject to talk about. Jason Michael, what you got? I mean, she ain't got the finest, but yeah.
So I think the point we should all gather from this entire subject is that SlyFox said, right? There is the breast, which is used for breastfeeding, right? To feed a child who is an infant and is incapable of sustaining themselves on their own.
Yeah.
And anything outside of that, so anything beyond a year, right? According to medical recommendation, is no longer benefiting the child. So if you're pulling out your breast to feed your child in public and that child is less than 1 year old, right? Then there should be nothing wrong with that. If your child is older than 1 year old and you're pulling that out and producing a environment that creates a controversy, then you're wrong.
He's fucking 4 years old.
If he's 4 years old and you're pulling out your tit in public to feed your 4 year old, feed your 4 year old, and then you're
Okay, Jason, I got a question for you. I don't know if you've seen, have you seen Game of Thrones?
Yes.
Okay, so Robin Aaron was a teen and he was still sucking on his mom's tit. Nothing sexual was about that. It was, for some reason, he was underdeveloped or whatever the fuck was going on with him.
In the books, they demonstrate that was the purpose of that was training. It was training to induce a condition of of codependency. So that there was no way that teen could make a decision without
his mom's. Yeah. Correct. I agree. That's awesome. Thank you. That's what I needed. All right, let's go forward so we can get out. Benita, you got some titty talk because I was getting off
just,
the titty.
You see, it's stirring the pot.
Oh my god,
so. It is stirring the pot. But some women get aroused from that. That's all.
From what? The baby sucking the titties or the man's?
Well, look how he rubbing on them.
Oh, he is. I bet she loved it. That is. Stop. Could you stop?
I just wanted to fuck with y'all heads a little bit before we go to the next subject.
Bruh, her Instagram name. Her Instagram name is Miss Calcium Cannons.
Miss Calcium what? But I wonder.
Miss Calcium Cannons.
Some people have an issue with.
Spell it.
Oh, you better learn how to spell calcium.
But I wonder if some people have an issue with that they maybe don't realize, or men anyway, is they might see a titty and get aroused and then see a baby being nurtured, and it's like these complex feelings that come with that. Because the same thing happened with women. You feeding a child and, you know. It happens. We human. I think we need to accept each other as being human. And that there's complex shit that go on with the human body.
Okay, I'm with it. I 100% agree with that. Oh my god, could you stop? Could you stop, sir? Could you please stop showing these over exaggerated, deflated at the same time boobies?
I did not give consent for you to put my Instagram up there.
Oh my god, I hope that ain't yours because them hoes look. They big and flat.
If they take that cape off and it's a man? How y'all go?
I want to talk. No, next subject.
And we're back to that now.
Ladies and gentlemen. Ladies and gentlemen, let's talk about this. Okay. We had a moment. I'm about to cut this dude video off. We had a moment earlier in the week where we talked about the work bay. All right, yeah, I remember we were talking about that. Okay, so I'm gonna put myself in a situation. All right, me and my wife at home, husband and wife. She go to work, she work in a hotel. She has 70% dudes working there, or as far as management goes. She decides that she has a work hubby. All right. I don't know exactly what that entails. I mean, you put your imagination where you want it to go for a work hubby to go. I go to work. I got a work wife. It is what it is. So are we okay with this? I'm going to go around the room one at a time so we can get it in. Are we okay with this? Is this something that's cool or not? Because I got mixed reactions in the group for this one. This was crazy. So let me start at the bottom. Dr. Renee, you did post on the comments. So what do you have to say about it?
I did. I don't even remember.
You said absolutely not.
Oh.
You said yeah, because, work.
Go ahead. Yeah, I don't believe in I'm married. Why would I have a work hubby? I mean, to me that's like something childish.
I can see that. Okay. All right, bet. Fansicle, where you at with it? Work you got a work wife?
Fucking bent, bro.
You got me bent.
Because all right, so like first off, you're spending a majority of your time at a job, and that's just kind of saying you could just say, it's one of my closer friends at work. You putting that kind of little crush title on it, that's all you're doing is saying she's the one that I like at work, or vice versa, or you know what, whatever.
I got the opportunity, I smashed.
Pretty much.
Yeah. Okay. Bet. Steve, where you at with it?
Man, all right, let's hear it. I'm 50-50 with that shit still. Like, bro, I'm like, look here. Let me ask you a question. Like, between two people and 100K, 50K ain't shit, bro. Between two people.
True. No, I ain't think about it like that, but that's true.
You know what I mean? So, I mean, like, bro, I love the cooperation between me and my lady. I look at her like my equal. You know what I mean? Like, she just like me. So, I'm just like her. You know what I mean? We see the same shit. We do the same shit. We grind the same shit. We love the same shit. It is what it is.
Where you be going? I swear you be going. But let me tell you this, though. From what I got from what you said, though, you said something important right there. You it devalues relationship. You said she went from being $1,000 to 50,000 to 50, whatever, $100,000 to 50,000, just off the fact you splitting it, and that's real right there. I can see that. That's what's up. Okay, Benita and Jason, where y'all at with it? Work wife, work hubby.
We didn't hear the whole premise, but I'm kind of, you know, somewhere in between Van Sigel and Dr. Renee. And a little bit of what I gathered from what Steve was saying is, one, I think, I mean, you're probably spending too much time at work. Mm. If you've got like a whole relationship that you committed to, say, identifying this person in your life, you're spending maybe too much time at work. And then I think, yeah, it does devalue, you know, because this is my husband. We went through some shit to be husband and wife. Like, yeah. What y'all doing at work?
You go through shit at work. You got deadlines.
You do, but it ain't the same thing as what I do with this dude waking up, going to bed with him, and, you know,
smelling his funky breath. Mm-hmm. Asking, did he wash? Did you wash?
You know what I'm saying? Like, it's just, you know, this is somebody I decided I didn't want to annoy for the rest of my life. I don't know if I want to do that with this work dude.
Facts. I think
it does a little bit of devalue. I don't know.
What about you, Jason?
It depends on the dynamic. So, like, if it's something to the point where it's threatening, I guess, your traditional monogamous relationship, and, like, somebody's catching feelings at work to the point where you're not actually expressing that to your real partner,
where you been? Nigga,
then I understand why that might be problematic. But at the end of the day, if you're talking about somebody that you just fuck with at work, that's just you cool with, you're friends with, and y'all just close, then, yeah, I mean, I think it's fine, you know? I think that... At the end of the day, as long as we have that understanding, like, if you're letting me know that you got friends at work, then cool. But, like, there are some cats that look at it from the standpoint of, like, no, you my woman.
What's her name?
I mean, you could just say that instead of dissing your partner, though. Like, that's disrespectful to your partner.
Hey, you had your turn, sir. Shit.
Well, I don't know. Is you agreeing? We need to, we'll be back.
All right.
I don't know if I'm agreeing with you. I'm just saying... It just comes down to what your relationship dynamic is. If y'all friends, then that's fine. But if it's a romantic thing and you like kind of hiding it from your partner, that's problematic.
He always like that. You know, he respectful. Yeah. He be respectful.
That's such a bad thing.
I want to see you disrespect one person. One time.
Where you at, KO? I want you to be disrespectful one time. What you got, KO?
Out of sight, out of mind first. I'm okay with anything that I don't know until I know. Then I have a problem with it.
So she's saying she got a work hubby to her homegirls or whatnot. It's fine. But once you hear it, it's like, now you got to investigate.
Well, my thing is this. I can't be mad about something I don't know.
Mm.
That's what I'm saying. It's fine.
Ignorance is bliss.
I don't see the issue... I mean, I don't see the need for it. I mean, I can come fuck at work if that's what you want. I mean,
Oh, wow. Well, let me ask you this, Kay, since you made that point. If you don't know about it, that means she's hiding it from you, right? So you're okay with her hiding it from you, and because that means she has no problem lying to you.
What I'm saying is, deal with what's in front of you. I'm not going looking for this shit. When it come out, I'll... make my decisions accordingly.
All right. Bet.
That's a good way to manage, if, you know, if it works.
It's a way to manage like that. This.
Your
manage
mental health.
And manage this.
You direct message me that, Steve.
Everything comes to the light.
Steve said I can agree with that, KO. He direct messaged me that, though.
Keep you sane, for sure.
Y'all,
Does anybody want to know where RB get this nice chair from? I need one. No, fuck that chair. I was wondering about this short sleeve hoodie.
That's what I was looking at. I like that.
I need that chair to play video games.
They make short sleeve hoodies?
Yeah, RB got on one right now. Unless he cut the sleeves. He cut the sleeves, huh?
Nope, bought it like that.
Let me see the seams then.
Let me see the hem. I want to see the
hem.
It's got the stitching, right?
Three account. Check his three account. Okay. Jason Michael, I got two, and then we got RB.
So my position on it is there's a difference between like that statement that you make that's like, oh, that's my work hubby or my work wife, and it's joking around, like the label doesn't designate that that is a romantic situation. However, if it is a romantic situation, if that significant other feels like they're in love or they're having romantic feelings about someone that they work with, right? Then you shouldn't have got married in the first place, because now you just opened up a Pandora's box and chaos will pursue. If you feel like there is somebody at work that you're working with that you relate to because you guys are in the trenches and you're dealing with it together, and then you have some kind of romantic feeling like, man, this person gets me more than the person at home, then yeah, that's a problem. That's a problem. And you're not going to tell your significant other that's happening, because if you did, that would be a problem, right? That would be something you would have to get through. So you're not going to do that because you don't want to deal with that fallout. So I'm not okay with it.
Oh, I'm muted. I'm sorry. Yeah, I think that's where the problem comes in. I think it's the relationship already rocky, because when you got trust issues, you don't add on to the trust issues with having this, because you got two options. I'm not going to say nothing because he already don't trust me, or she already don't trust me, or... well, she don't trust me, so let me make sure I tell her this or him this, and then you bring on a whole nother issue. So what's the big deal? All right, hold on, tell you, I got Steve, and then I got Vansicle.
I just think that, like, when you're dealing with relationships and everything else like that, trust is so, it's so minuscule. It's like, it's a thin line and everything else like that. Like, once you break that, it's like it's hard to come from up that. So I have no say of that because I've been on both sides of it. So I'm gonna throw my hands up on
that. All right, facts. I feel you. Vansick, what you got?
All right, so I'm gonna relate it to this, and I do agree. If someone just said that, oh, he's like my work hubby at work, because we were like cooler than most people at work, I get that. But if someone kept referring to me as that, I don't know if we've ever had this conversation in the group, but it's kind of one of them things where if a girl says he's like a brother to me, because let me tell you right now, every time a girl has said that about me, she wanted to smash. He's like a brother to me. I'm like, don't ever tell your boyfriend that, because I know you just been waiting for your fucking chance. Now I'm different. If I ever said a girl was like a sister to me, that means she is sexually off limits. But I have seen girls that say that about dudes they will smash.
I've said it trying to convince myself.
Thank you for that.
Because I have all my brother's friends.
Like, please don't. All right, RB, what's your status on this one?
I don't think that shit okay, and here's why.
Uh-oh.
Because I ain't gonna claim nobody as a work wife or anything that I ain't trying to fuck or I wouldn't fuck. So let's just keep it a buck on that one. Like, you're not gonna claim somebody that close that you're not attracted to. So to even hide it or bring it to your spouse like it's supposed to be okay, that's just like straight disrespect anyway.
I'm with it.
Because I'm not gonna be like, oh yeah, that's just work bae if she looking like Big Shirley from the term security.
Right. Now there you go. Now you got, and then see, that's another part of it that nobody said nothing about. We talking about work bae or work hubby, but what she look like? Because if you ain't calling no quote, I'm sorry that I'm using these numbers again. You ain't calling no three work bae. You know what I'm saying? You're not gonna be sitting there talking about, oh yeah, that's just work bae, and she a three. Back. She gonna be like
fruit a, by the foot.
Back. She gonna be a
she
a,
look like Vivica Fox and be she like, yo, good. Work bae. I mean, really?
You're making this so much worse.
Hey, it is what it is. They're eating snacks and shit and talking about Big Shirley and shit. It goes down like that.
But it usually happens when
you put quotes around it.
They're not getting what they need at home. They're finding that empteness, being filled by that person at work. And then it's that one situation where they light that spark, right? That one thing that they feel like is empty, and now it's full because I want to go to work every day so I can get that.
Well, it's full. You have to go to work, and so this person's giving you attention because you ain't getting it while you're at work. And what, so, like, what, yeah, that's the work home. Life.
Why does it always got to be a justification? Maybe somebody's fucking greedy.
That's true. Wow,
that person at home could be doing whatever they can and doing everything they can do, but you just want more, so you make up an excuse to justify why you doing what the fuck you doing.
I agree with IB. That's probably more.
I like that nigga, but I agree with him.
I agree with RB. That's probably more than not the case.
Nah, he got a great point. That's a good point. You got motherfuckers that be like, what's it say, had your cake and eat it too? And what boy say?
Well, I made two cakes.
Look, sings a song. Bruce Springsteen sings a song, right? Bruce Springsteen sings a song about a guy who wants the family life. I want my family. I want the dynamic that I got, right? But I also want to, you know, I want my wonder.
Nicole!
I want my wanderlust.
I want to find a house. That's what he said.
Yeah, but that's a rock star. Of course, that's what he was doing, man.
I mean, but that's
who actually make it wrote right. that song, though.
But I mean, that's just
Hungry like Heart. Hungry Heart is the exemplification of that situation.
3000 was
fuckboy behavior, bro.
Hey, yo, 3000 was speaking on it. What you had three?
But I say that's just like just making up excuse, you know. And with a lot of situations, it's like. When somebody cheat, well, why did you cheat? And it's like, the end result is you cheated. You know, we keep giving people ways out, and it's just, that's what the fuck they wanted to do.
Right?
I think the why does matter, though. If the symptom of the why might matter if I want to stay with you, the why definitely is going to matter.
I mean, it at the end of the day, it doesn't matter because if it was that bad, then leave.
I don't know.
I mean, because if you go into, and I'm saying it on that aspect, if you go into that aspect, I can always give you a retort that can balance out your why. So it's like, it's bullshit.
Yeah. Hold on. KO got his hand up. What you got, KO? All right. Remember that question, Benita.
I'm with y'all on all this. It's just, it seemed like when it do finally happen after all this play in between the two of them, the thing I hate is when they try to, like, they all went out for drinks that worked together. They blame it on the alcohol. Like you said, like RB says, stuff that they already want to do, because I ain't never got drunk and sucked no penis, and it ain't gonna happen. So you can't blame certain stuff.
Have you ever got sober and sucked some penis? That's the real question.
No, it's the exact same thing. He's like my brother. It's the exact same thing, man.
Right.
Yeah. But when they
somebody out of the two, you had it in them.
That part. I just know, don't blame it on alcohol. You ain't ever sucked no penis and been drunk.
All right, Benita, what you have?
Well, no, I was trying to see from what point of view
Aubrey's
answer was coming from. I think I may have missed it.
Okay.
Because he said when you come from that aspect, I wasn't sure which aspect he was
talking. I'm saying if you choose to say, well, this is my reason for cheating, it's always going to be a retort on why you couldn't have or why you shouldn't have. You can say, okay, well, you don't spend enough time with me. Well, shit, I work 90 hours a week to pay for the car you drive all the time. I mean, that's it could always be something. You know, people could say they can justify their why, but at the end of the day, it's just like, if your situation that bad, why not be done with the whole situation and start fresh without having to sneak or do all of that extra shit?
I got a question for everybody based off of what we're talking about now. Because some people tend to make everything a whole, a relationship as a whole. But there are different aspects to relationships. So, when you say that if the situation is that bad, why don't you just leave? What if everything about the situation is bad itself that got good sex, and you still want to hit that.
It ain't that bad. That's what I'm saying.
But now the situation ain't that bad. You just want the sex, but you don't want nothing else about it.
On the couch.
But everything else, you know. I feel like that's the wrong question to ask me because
Hold on. RB, what happened?
I said that's the wrong question to ask me because, like I said before, I'm so desensitized to sex and never had a problem getting it. Like, go with your crazy ass and good sex and fuck somebody else's life up.
But you ain't never had that one. You don't got one in your particular mind that you can think of who had the best that you done had.
Don't mean I want to fuck with them because they get on my fucking nerve.
Mm. Okay.
I mean, okay, let me ask you something. How many of my exes have I ran back to?
One.
I'm asking for an honest answer.
I'm sorry. Was you talking to me? I'm sorry.
I just said one. Oh, okay. I said one.
Who?
I don't know. I was seeing if she was gonna say it.
Wait, I didn't know. Wait, did I miss something?
Steve said two.
What was the question?
Who?
Who, Steve? Hold on, I'm gonna give you the question in a minute. I gotta see this. But who, Steve?
Hey, man, look, I just my ex,
but crazy. I thought he was asking the damn question.
He's been holding that two up before that, bro.
What you got, Jason? Steve had his hand up. That was him throwing his hand up.
Crazy sex. I'm talking about, like, yo, her daughter in the fucking living room.
Jason Michael, what you got?
Look, her daughter in the living room and everything else like that and everything.
Steve, stop.
So what about the relationship where the significant other wants the whole family dynamic, they like the life that they're living, right? But they want to sleep with somebody else, not that they want to be with somebody else. They just want to sleep with somebody else.
I don't know how many times we got to go over this. It's called swingers. Get you a swinger, girl. You're good to go.
They might be poly, and they might need to explore that.
Yeah, and maybe you should try it. I mean, I don't necessarily think it's a bad thing. It's not a good thing necessarily, but at the same time, try the shit out. See if it works.
If you don't like it, just break up. Yeah.
I mean, at least try.
Alone is an option.
At least try it.
I mean, to answer your question, nobody likes to be forced into anything. So if you hide it from them and don't bring it to them as your significant other, whatever happens, happens.
RB, you got to talk to your boy. Steve said, what did I do wrong? He got
mad. No, he's slurring. I don't think he knows he's slurring.
He drunk. Stop serving that man. Cut him off.
I'm not drinking anything.
I'm talking about Steve. Did you see, man, what he wrote?
Look, he came here like that, man.
Oh, you damn.
Oh, he in the house with you?
He arrived. Mm-hmm. He at RB house. He came from Beaumont. That's hilarious. KO, you got your hand up. What's up?
That's hilarious. To the question that you asked. I believe not everybody is for the same reason in your life. So you got to allow motherfuckers to play the roles in your life that they meant to play. And hers might be shut up and bend over.
Oh, my God. You're right.
Wait. They got people you talk to about stuff when it's bothering you. You got the party person, and then you got the shut up and bend over person.
That comes from a place of singleness, though. Because I've been there, done that, and you're exactly right.
But your question was pertaining to after finding out, though. What do you do if everything is bad, but that one thing is good? That was for the question.
You put her in that spot. She's that person now.
Precisely. If she's that best you ever had, like you said.
Yo.
Come through. I'll let you when I see you again.
What if that person was like the best head, the best sex, best everything, all in one person? Because that ain't never been that one. It's never been that one. Never been that one.
Crack will give you the best high ever, but you stay away from it, huh?
And it's only the best.
I never tried it, though. Time. That's the difference. I never tried it. I tried that thing, you know what I'm saying? So, you know.
She only be the best one time.
What you got? What you got, Tay?
All right, man, like, you if you have enough sex, dude, there will be, like, the best. There will be the more sex you have, there will be fuck. Like I said, we talked about body counts. I got over 300. Like, there's still a few I remember. I don't be thinking about that shit. But I'm just saying, that's not a stable person to have a relationship with. You know what I'm saying? Like, if like that shit ain't that important, man. Like, if somebody's unstable and not good for you, yeah, just bend them over, like you said. But like what Matt said, that's a single part of your life. You had to go through that and experience that. But if you want to settle down, and be with somebody, then like, I mean, sex has got to be important, dude. It definitely does. but I mean, damn, the one that rocked your world, man. Like, if they're unstable, that's just not good. Trust, it could get you stabbed.
Yeah, there you go. That's your bad.
When y'all talk about sex, there's sex and intimacy.
No, we're just talking about sex. We're not talking about intimacy.
Well, then, yeah, like, it doesn't matter. You can let it go.
Well, that's the thing. That's the point. If everything is bad except for the sex, then the intimacy is obviously off the board. It's just sex.
Right.
True. So if you got somebody that's intimacy, if the intimacy is not an issue, then you don't really move off of that easily.
And sex matters in a relationship, but it is not the one saving grace you have when everything else is shitty.
Yeah, if you suck at life, but you're good at sex, we will keep you around for sex.
You still suck.
Yeah. But you gotta be really good. No, it's gotta be, but it's gotta be in a hierarchy of needs. It's gotta be a top need. You know what I'm saying? For somebody to just be like, okay, to risk your mental health and stuff. It's got to be something like a strong need, I feel like.
Whose mental health
y'all
are we
risking out too much? Y'all giving out too much from the beginning. That's all it is. You got to hit them with the D because they can't handle the A game. Once you get the A game, shit change.
What if you're not the best they've ever had?
Hey, man.
That's part of the problem right there.
No, what I'm saying part is of the if somebody problem. Is still in a committed relationship with you, you are serving a need for them. It's a need, babe. Like, that's what we do as humans. You are
not everybody's a Cain, bro. In their life.
He asked a serious question. You with somebody, and what if you not the best they ever had? What if y'all had this conversation before when y'all was drunk and y'all talk, you know what? You're not even the best dick I ever had. I'm so-and-so John Jangle was the one. Ooh, that one. Don't worry about it. Y'all doing too much. All right, so.
What? Hold on.
It's being recorded. So.
I know. Damn it.
Either learn and do better or kick them to the curb.
Well,
you're not with somebody who's not.
It's not exactly. But if you're not with somebody for the sex, then that doesn't matter. Like, if you don't have to have. I didn't say that the person that I'm with now is the best sex I ever had. I didn't say that. I did not say that either because this is recorded. So, but at the same time,
smart man right there.
But at the same time, that's not one of those situations that I'm not going to base my answer or me and her answers might be different. That shouldn't be something that come up, I don't think. But if she asked me, am I going to be honest with her? Yeah, it's not gonna be recorded, but I'm gonna tell it. we're gonna talk about it.
Maybe I didn't say that line.
Right? Nah, I ain't said it. We're talking about throw the red flag, the commercial. Y'all see that?
Niggas be going screenshotting, man.
But yeah, so no, it's not gonna be recorded. It's not gonna be
written,
or none of that shit. It's gonna be talked out, and it's gonna be done. We're gonna have a bunch of drinks first, and then we're gonna talk about it. But
maybe you was drunk.
If that situation, if you're staying with somebody. Because you want to be with that person, I think that holds more weight than, oh, I'm going to break up with you because you don't like my sex. Like, what? If you want to be with somebody, you're going to be with somebody. If the sex is the problem, then, I mean, like I said, explore other options. They have other options out there.
Sometimes it's more important to not be alone and be with somebody who is the best sex you ever had.
Right. I watched The House of Usher. The Fall of the House of Usher on HBO or whatever it was. It was on Netflix. And they had one chick on there. Who, she was the breadwinner, but she didn't want to. have sex with her husband. So she paid bitches to come over there and fuck her husband while she sit there and watch him masturbate. I was like, if you don't masturbate, why not just fuck him? Like, what the fuck?
But I've seen something like that, yeah.
That shit weird. Okay, I got hands up. Bicycle, and then KO, what you got?
All right, so yeah, like if you're in a relationship with somebody, if that's not the conversation that's coming up, if you ain't asking some weird shit like that, man, you could opt to not want to know. But if that's where the conversation is, yes, be honest about it. But yeah, like, yeah. Now what you're saying, Matt, is if somebody's been like just petty and like, well, I've been dick down better, you know what I'm saying? Like, bitch, go and get out and go get them then. You know what I'm saying? Like, if somebody's going to be hurtful and fucking, if you're not fulfilling up to their fucking needs, it's better for both of you to just fuck off and get on about your business, as far right. as I'm concerned. You know,
if she's throwing like, it in your face.
Yeah, yeah like, and, yeah. and vice versa, if you had the audacity to be I've had better sex. Because if you're still thinking about that other sex, like I said, like, you could have sex with a lot of people, and you can think of a couple times in your life where it was monumental, but like, that's not something you just think about unless it comes up in conversation. Right. And if that's something you want to use against somebody, then that's obviously a failure that you're getting in that relationship. And at that point, you can either fix it or forfeit.
Well, I mean, that's part of the whole thing we always talk about, accountability. And if accountability can't be the answer, then it's not worth talking about. Because if you can sit there and have a conversation with somebody, and y'all can hash out what this is and what this ain't, then you not being the best sex that they ever had won't be an issue. Like, okay, so what do I need to do to be the best? Or is there a way Preach. That I can be the best? Like,
that's
I mean,
what I've been saying. And if you can't deal with it, then dip out.
Yeah, if you can't fix it and they not happy with it, then y'all need to move on. If you can't fix it, but they're okay with it, it is what it is. You tried at least. That's what they should be doing. Like, damn, at least he's trying, you know, or she's trying, you know. That's how I feel about it. That's all.
Yeah, then it's just non-existent because it's just, you know, you're just in a relationship, and you know, you deal with that absence of that.
Right? Yeah. Have you seen Don John, Jason Michael?
That's a good movie. I've seen it.
He was. Good. I think, dude, I don't know why they casted him, per se. But
he wrote it.
He wrote it. Okay, that makes sense then. Okay.
Yeah.
That makes
sense. He was trying to get his himself. Rocky on, you know what I'm saying? He directed it. I think, yeah. Did he direct it too?
No, I know that. He wrote it. Of course I'm going to cast Scarlett Johansson. Of course.
That was his debut. So it was his directorial debut too. So he did
It wasn't a bad movie. It was actually
for all of that, I think it was good. Yeah. But to me, it's about SlyFox, and I talked about it before. For me, the movie's about intimacy and the difference between intimacy and sex. But I don't want to ruin it too much.
Yeah,
but,
check it out. Let's talk about it next week. Good. Don John, I'm going to put that on the board. Oh, my stomach just growled. I guess I got to go to yips now. Don John. All right.
Yeah, I'm really a little jelly that y'all doing a whole menu thing. Is that what Creighton does? Is he like the chef or something?
Yeah, they don't work at Yelp's no more. So anywho, yeah, we'll talk about it later, I guess. KO, what you got? Your hands up. I got another.
Please, gentlemen. I just wanted to disagree with Benita's premise of the need part. Because
it's a premise?
Wait, hold on. What's up? What we saying?
I agree with your views on it about it being a necessity. Because it's not the same for us. We get the same by ourselves. You women, y'all get different types of climaxes based off of how y'all squirt, y'all do all kind of stuff. Men have the same climax. Mm-mm. You know what I'm saying?
No. No, bro.
I don't know.
No.
Hey, nah. Okay.
I was only really
hell no.
So, sometimes it ooze out, sometimes it shoot like a foul.
Who said no? Definitely got pegged because.
So, sometimes
got like pegged.
That's the only way y'all feeling the different one, I guess.
Wow.
It come out the same place, the same exact way. Do you squirt? Do y'all squirt?
Hey, hey, we can't respectfully disagree without you insulting us to get your point across.
You one of the people that said something, because I seen those two Arkansasians say no. I didn't say anything.
I precisely said that sometimes it oozes out, sometimes it shoots out, sometimes it's a little pre-cum. Like I said the actual ways that it's different.
Did we just get attacked?
Yeah, we did just get attacked from being from a great state.
Who attacked us? What happened?
Not you. Oh, you're not from Arkansas. You're not from Arkansas.
I'm not even from Arkansas, but I got a little bit of that one.
So if I pour water out of a cup, out of a spout, out of a spoon, the way it comes out makes it different?
Yes,
the pressure it comes out makes it feel different. Because when I get that big hot, when that shoots, I be feeling drained.
What I'm saying is, their shit look exactly different from each other.
Our shit do too,
and dicks don't. Come on, man.
I'm sorry. What happened with dicks?
Oh my God. I'm playing.
Dicks look different, vaginas look different. Okay, all of them look different. Each one is a different experience. If you can't say that, then you got the problem, sir.
Prove they different looking.
You got stuff like this, and then you got stuff like this. Okay, big difference. Okay.
Sometimes my nip be on repeat, and I be about to pass out.
What happened, RV?
My nut be on repeat and I be about to pass out.
Yeah, like it's different. Like
sometimes I be lightheaded.
And to say that is to quote my favorite pop star, Michael Jackson, it's ignorant. Because I can sit here and masturbate and I can bust three different ways because of how I stroke it. So I mean, come on, man.
And dare say the woman doesn't. You know what I'm saying? With the shower head or with you hitting or whatever, you know, different strokes for different folks. Literally.
Yeah. We keep cucumbers around here, bro.
No. Damn. Oh, salad's being made.
don't eat a salad at Jason and Benita house.
Jason gonna invite everybody over. You can sit on the couch. He's like, you guys want some salad? Like, nah, we
appreciate it.
So, all right, let's get this. We got 13 minutes. Remember, when the clock strikes 11,
I'm putting everybody off, that go. Just let y'all know.
When the clock strikes 11, the $5 deal is off. So don't be trying to hit me up at 11:01 talking about, hey man, the deal. Like, nah. All right. So here it is.
I want my money back.
The offer you offered your U'RE. You're offered $100 million to watch your whole life on TV with your entire family. Will you do it? Let's go. Dr. Renee. I'm talking about every single scene that you've seen in your life.
Can we clarify? Are you saying 100 million or 1 million?
100 million. 100 million. Yeah, Dr. Renee, what you got?
Yes, I would, because I ain't got nothing to hide.
Facts. Okay. Dr. Nay never did no diddly. You don't want nobody to see.
There you go.
Okay. Dr. Steve, why your legs crossed like this? Steve living his best life with them locks on. Steve. Don't cut the camera, Steve. Answer the question. Steve.
No. Fuck no. Fuck
why not?
Nigga, because I got a lot of shit to hide. Nigga, shit. Hey, look here, man. I don't know. Y'all some good people. I'm not.
I mean, it depends on
Let's just stop it at that.
Okay. I respect that. He said, nah. All right. Van Sickle, what you got?
You fucking bet, bro. I can get paid for that? That sounds awesome because I'm an open book to everybody. Everybody Thanks. I meet, you already know. My family, they already know all the crazy shit I've done. Your family knows the crazy shit I've done. Like, I got nothing to hide. If I can get paid for that, if they want to sit through that crazy-ass movie, they can.
There you go.
Hey, I'll take my money and walk away while they watch it. I don't even dare. Y'all, let me know when y'all finish. I'll be in the behind.
I haven't done anything like. I mean, nobody should be doing anything you're ashamed of, dude. If you're ashamed, shame is important. You got to learn a lesson from something you're ashamed of. I have done things. Who hasn't done things they're ashamed of?
You're but pissing like, in my tree in my living room.
I wasn't that ashamed of that. I was drunk. Not pissing, you know, but he was
watering your tree. Okay?
Yeah, he watered my.
I was sleepwalking while I was drunk,
bro. And he cared enough to ask if you had nicks.
But hey, you know, just like most things that. Just like most things that we talk about, it goes back to accountability, bro. I take accountability for the things I've fucked up in my life. I'm not hiding them. Mm. I learned from them and didn't do them again.
Mm. Or sometimes I did, just to try, see if it worked. All right, bet. Benita and Jason, what y'all got? One at a time, please. Not together, because I can see a difference coming on.
Nah, I ain't even tripping, bro. Like, it's $100 million, so like, whatever embarrassing shit I need to get over, I'm gonna get over. But that's $100 million fucking dollars.
Yes, indeed.
Period.
All right. But Nita,
you can
at?
Pay people to forget.
I'm sorry, I'm just really thinking about, you know.
You can only pay
my dad seeing my sexual encounters.
Like, why does everybody mind immediately go to the sexual shit they done? Y'all some freaks, man. Y'all gotta calm this shit down.
I'm telling you, but only because it's indoors. Like,
I'm talking about the illegal activities, hiding bodies and stuff, y'all.
Oh, they ain't finding anybody.
So, I mean, if they watch your videos, they is.
Oh, fuck. Yeah, and so you can't watch it. You can't take the money and walk off while they watching it. You can get paid until the credits rolling, bro. So you gonna have to stay there and watch and get all this. I can't believe all that. But I thought you were saying $1
million. $100 million.
I think I could do it, because I think $100 million could buy me.
You gonna let your dad sit there and watch all your sexual escapades just for $100 million?
I don't think he gonna watch it. I think he gonna walk out, bro. I swear to God, I don't think he gonna leave. All
right, KO, what you got on this one?
It's not me that needs to be worried. It's you people that calls yourselves my friends, because my precious granny will see how y'all be fucking me.
Man, your granny probably be like, why are they still his friend after how he fucked up?
He did.
I never thought about that. Yeah, the co-stars. Yeah.
Yeah, I did the disclaimer on mine. Jason Michael, what about you?
So can you reiterate the question?
All right. You get offered $100 million to have your entire family watch your entire life. You take it or no?
Absolutely, I take it.
Okay.
I'll take it because that's what they're going to pay me for my memoir.
Hey, you're about to tell all book, right? But see, that's the...
It ain't just me. Because in my life, if they had a camera on me from the time I was born to the time that now, everybody and their brother would be in it.
Everybody. That's true.
So, throw stones at me if you want, but you're going to be in there.
Right now, you and Kevin are right. It's not
everything.
About what we
do. That arises other questions, though. That arises more questions than answers. Is that snitching?
Man, God damn.
They're going to be watching with you. So they're going to see.
Give me $100 million.
That's not snitching. Man. That's accountability.
A lot of y'all going to be getting exposed. A lot of y'all going to be getting exposed for conversations you never thought people was going to hear and stuff. Y'all be getting exposed.
You know what they're going to see? They're going to see me at 15 years old.
Man, Rob.
Shelter.
Rob.
New York City at 15 years old with nobody and no one helping me. That's staying bad. In a shelter in New York City and someone trying to steal my shoes. An adult. A 20-something adult trying to steal a
15-year-old. They're going to see the trauma.
Did you That's kill them, though?
They're going to see the kid in the cell who had everybody else in the cell on his team say, I want your glasses because they help me see better than I see now. And me stand up and confront him. And then the entire cell of 26 people stand up to try to beat me down because I confronted him not to steal my glasses.
But did you kill one?
That's what they're going to see.
But But did you kill my mom?
That's what I'm looking for. Though. I want the best. Like, my mind went right to the sex, but I didn't think about the trauma that caused.
But did you see the facts? Did you see the fact that God prevailed and everything else like that?
Are you still here? With that silver lining.
Did you see
that I held my t-shirt?
You still held what?
I would let them see my entire life. Let them see it all.
Can you turn down the
what do I do now? Please. I'm a software engineer that makes six figures.
Why are you calling my name, bro?
I'll tell you, let him finish, because you was rooting them on, but as you was rooting them on, you was cutting them off too. I mean, it was he was having his moment, but while he was having his moment, you was saying, okay. Yes, brother, yes, but it was cutting him out, like his actual vocals.
Okay. My bad. I'm sorry.
Yeah. It's all good. But yeah, we got the gist of it. Like, dude, you're going to see the shit that I went through. I did my thing. I held it down. I ain't back down for no bitch ass shit or nothing like that. So I feel you. RB, what's your answer on this one?
Shit, I'll be all right. My mama called Lil 5 seconds of my sex tape when I was in high school. So it wouldn't be nothing to surprise her.
I want to know who's done that. Have y'all recorded women and they ain't know?
No.
They have to be about it.
Yeah, hey, you go to jail for that shit. SlyFox had the funniest one because she was riding him and he started doing sit-ups to make sure his ass was open.
Hey, I was very vain at that moment in my life. It was all about my... I had the perfect abs at that moment. But I was like, look at this.
You would be surprised how many women are cool with it if they're about you. Yeah. You know,
you just ask them. Hey, you gotta ask, be
upfront about it.
I had an addiction. I used to have every girl.
They want the video too.
Every girl I slept with at one point in my life, I got a video of them sucking my cock.
Yes,
one man that's like, oh. No,
all right, well, check this out. My, I posted it in the thing, and I said, I don't have a problem with it. The idea of it's just you gotta blur out everybody else's face. Like, you can keep mine, but nigga, like the co-stars, the cast, the crew, like some of the shit, they not getting paid for it. And I ain't sharing my money either. So blur their ass out. I'm keeping my 100 million, and you know, it is what it is. You can say what you want
to
say.
We don't pay promoters.
You can talk shit about me, but talk shit about me while I'm on my yacht, bruh. That's it.
What's up? I can't hear you on this satellite phone.
Can't hear you. What? Hold on, let me pull my antenna up some more. Yeah. All right. So I don't know if y'all noticed or not, but a lot of y'all didn't notice. This is the right way. When you fuck around with the pitchers, this is how you're supposed to pour the top part whenever you got it full. So that's crazy.
No.
Who the fuck didn't know that, bro?
Hell no, bro. Come on, dog.
That's crazy. That's how you do it. Fill that bitch up. And then,
you know what? I saw that, and
the little triangle spout?
That's after it's not full no more.
When it's further down.
When I saw that picture, I had made something with milk yesterday, and I poured the milk in my cup, and I poured it out the side like the way you just showed it. I was like, oh shit.
How's that Trump mean go?
I just want to know why everybody's so aggressively dismissive of it. Like, I'm not fucking doing that.
Somebody put all caps. I will never do this. I was like, damn.
I will never do this.
That was cool.
That was hilarious.
I don't know if you know the one with the can opener.
We got 2 minutes left. What's the can opener one?
The can opener one, yes. You're not supposed to hold it on the side. You're supposed to
hold it flat down.
Yeah. Man, we got 2 minutes left. Somebody's trying to # all pores matter.
All pores? I'm just saying. If y'all haven't checked it out yet, me and my man Vance, or Von Doom, if you will, we put down a little live mix at my house. It was horrible because of the internet there sucked. And Vansickle would not let me use his hotspot, his Arkansas hotspot, to make it just clear. He had me
offered you like five times.
Is it on camera? Is it on camera?
And real quick, go look at that story. You only get 13 years for putting a hit on somebody. If they don't die.
Only 13?
If they don't die. If they don't
die. If they don't die.
Oh, that's so fucked up.
Conspiracy to attempted murder.
Yeah, that's mm-hmm. it. You know it.
They almost right, shot well, the nigga.
My goodbyes now before we get cut off. Good talking to y'all.
I don't right. y'all making me lose this bet, neither.
Hey, ain't nobody make you. Hey,
accountability.
Ladies and gentlemen, you have been stirring the pot with the studio.
Yeah, in the studio. In the studio, studio. Oh.
5191. Get off my line.